Hey, it's Karen, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be sharing three books that have had a really big impact on my life. But before I do that, please remember to hit that subscribe button because it really supports my channel. The three books that I'm going to talk about probably fall into the self-improvement category, so if this is something you're interested in, keep watching. So the first book that had a really big impact on me is The Four Agreements. This is a book, it's The Four Agreements by Don Miguel Ruiz. I like this book because it's very simple. Don Miguel Ruiz outlines four things that you can do in your life to make your life better and to make you a better person. If I feel like I'm a little bit off track or if I feel that I'm not living my best life, I turn to this book. The four agreements are: be impeccable with your word, don't take anything personally, never make assumptions, and always do your best. And I feel that if you can manage to do these four things in your life, you're doing pretty well. I think it's really important to have spiritual guidelines or spiritual practice in your life. That's something that I can talk about in another video if you're interested. The most influential of the four agreements for me has been to be impeccable with your word. This simply means that you do as you say, you don't say anything about somebody that you wouldn't say to their face, you don't gossip, etc. It's a really quick and easy read. As you can see, it's a pretty small book, so it's just something to turn to occasionally. I've actually also got the audiobook of this book, that's how much I love it. As I said, I just come back to it if I feel like I need a bit of a reminder of how I want to live my life, etc. I really recommend this book, it's great. The second book that had a massive impact on me is Man's Search for Meaning by Viktor Frankl. Viktor Frankl was a Holocaust survivor and a therapist. Dr. Frankl noticed that in the concentration camps, the individuals who were more likely to survive were those who had meaning in their lives. From this, he created a type of therapy which is called logotherapy. It's really interesting. If you're interested in therapy, I really suggest that you look it up and do a bit more research. The basic premise of logotherapy is that we all need meaning in our lives to be happy. For me personally, I think when I've been in periods of extreme depression, especially last year, it has been when the meaning in my life has gone. I think what I've learned about meaning is that it changes, and what used to be meaningful becomes maybe unmeaningful and you replace it with something else, and that's okay, it's kind of transient. I really recommend this book if you're going through a dark period in your life at the moment, and also if you're interested in therapy, I think you would enjoy this book as well. It's obviously very moving, but it's such an important read and I really recommend you give it a go. The final book that I'm going to recommend is Inward by Young Pueblo. Young Pueblo is a poet. I initially came across his work on Instagram, but I noticed that he was doing a reading in London last year, so I went to go see him read, and I purchased his book there whilst I was at his event. Inward is a collection of poems and thoughts that he has. They're very spiritual, so if you are into spirituality, you will enjoy this book. I keep this book in my bedroom and I've actually started just opening it up at a random page each morning and reading something from it. I just love his view of the world. I think that he views the world quite uniquely. The pieces of text that resonate with me most are probably about self-love and growth. And also he talks a lot about nature, which I really love and appreciate. I think sometimes we can get very bogged down in the day-to-day, and like I said, it's good to have a spiritual practice. I thought I'd read a couple of my favourites. I can only give to you what I have already given to myself. I can only understand the world as much as I understand myself. You have walked through fire, survived floods, and triumphed over demons. Remember this the next time you doubt your own power. I find this book very inspirational and very uplifting. It puts me in a very positive mindset. If you're interested in poetry and self-love and growth, and you like to put yourself in a positive mindset, I really recommend that you give this book a read. I'll also insert his Instagram somewhere on the screen so you can check him out on Instagram. Those were three books that have had a really big impact on me. I really hope that you enjoyed. Leave me a comment and let me know what books have influenced you. I would love to hear. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you on the next one.